Then it doesn't change policy. It's important to explain that because many people have been talking about policy change, new policy adoption. NGC does not change policy. It can review policy. If we have a policy in place, maybe we have problems with implementation or the detail. The NGC can apply its mind in the review, but it can't introduce new policies. It deals with challenges and problems that we confront in the implementation, and it identifies areas where new policies are needed. But once it has identified those new policies, the process of policy development begins. It will go to the policy conference and end up in the international conference in 2017. That is the only structure that can change policy. There are tasks that are given by the Constitution to the NEC of the NEC. Codes, processes, and all that. That review belongs to the NEC. If anybody raises it in the NGC for discussion, they will enrich that process beyond the NGC. You must remember that NGC doesn't implement, it deals with policies. The NEC implements. That's what is going to happen on this case. The beauty of an NGC or a conference of the NGC is that it's not a discussion of experts. It's a discussion of members of the ANC and interpret the policies as they impact on them. See, for example, if you talk about the RAND, it's a debate that is at our level. When it is weaker, it is favoring the export, but it is very heavy on the import sector. It is likely to help us reduce the deficit on the current account and all those things. That is high flying. What members will be asking is, how does this policy impact on jobs? How does that job impact on poverty, on inequality? That's what members of the NC will be asking. We have a responsibility as leadership to simplify complex economic concepts to make them understand.